The Valo and Valo Grand Curing Light comes with four rechargeable lithium ion phosphate batteries. This video will show you how to charge, change, and maintain your batteries and charger to ensure safe usage. The curing light signals the user that it is time to change the batteries when the low battery indicator light is flashing red. If the battery charge becomes too low, an audible 3-beep warning sound will occur, and the curing light will not allow further operation until batteries are recharged or new batteries are inserted. To charge the batteries, plug the charger into an electrical outlet in an office area, avoiding areas where disinfectant spray may come in contact with batteries. Insert the batteries into the charger with the positive ends pointed towards the indicator lights on the charger. Note, do not put non-rechargeable batteries in the Valo battery charger. The batteries will take up to an hour to charge. Leave the batteries in the charger until they're ready for use. Green lights will indicate that the batteries are ready for use. Pay attention to the charger during charging. Unplug the charger when it's not in use. Note, if the red light on the charger does not turn green when the batteries have been charging longer than 3 hours, the battery may be degraded or corrupted and cannot be charged. Replace with new batteries. To change and insert batteries, remove back cap by twisting counterclockwise 1/4 turn. Remove the batteries. Insert fresh batteries positive side first. Reattach back cap by aligning and gently pushing while twisting clockwise. Turn cap clockwise until it stops. The unit is ready for use. Fully charged battery life in the curing light is dependent on the mode and time interval, battery type, amount of use, and LED efficiency. In general, recharge batteries when the low battery indicator comes on, or approximately every 1 to 2 weeks, depending on use. The curing light comes with four rechargeable batteries. Rechargeable lithium ion phosphate batteries can be recharged repeatedly. Based on normal use and proper care, the battery should last a few years, but should be replaced as necessary. To avoid the risk of electrical fire associated with the handling of batteries, only use recommended batteries, as some rechargeable batteries can affect the function. Do not mix rechargeable batteries with non-rechargeable batteries or other battery types. Do not attempt to charge non-rechargeable batteries. Do not autoclave or spray batteries, battery contacts, charger, or AC power adapter with liquid of any kind. Do not charge batteries around flammable materials. Do not keep the charger in clinical operatory. To avoid the risk of injury, do not use batteries that are corroded, rusted, dented, emit an odor or fluids, have a torn or missing wrapping, or are otherwise damaged. To avoid damaging the equipment, do not insert fingers, instruments, or other objects into the battery compartment of the curing light. To avoid damaging the equipment, do not attempt to clean the gold contacts or any part of the battery compartment. If cleaning the battery charger becomes necessary, then unplug charger, dampen a cloth with isopropyl alcohol, and gently wipe the surface of the charger or batteries. Let the charger dry completely before resuming use. If storing the curing light for periods longer than 2 weeks, or packing it for travel, always remove the batteries. If batteries are left in the unit for long periods of time without recharging, they may become non-functional or unchargeable. Do not store batteries in temperatures over 60 degrees centigrade or in direct sunlight. When disposing of electrical waste, i.e. curing lights, chargers, batteries, and power supplies, follow local waste and recycling guidelines. If additional batteries or replacement batteries are needed, or there are concerns about batteries not charging, damaged parts, or cleaning the equipment, please contact Ultradent Customer Service or your sales representative.